Please be seated for 2 minutes. Идет? Okay, everybody, good evening. I'm going to say a couple of words to the Torah. It says in the beginning of the parasha, Ve'ebi shala paro et ha'am, when paro sent the nation, когда паро отправил народ, ולא נחם אלוקים דרך ארץ פלישתים, כי קרוב הוא. И Бог говорит, Бог не хотел брать по этой дороге. God did not want to take them дерех ארץ פלישתים, כי קרוב הוא was very close. And the nation will regret their coming out, and they're going to go back to Mitzrayim, right? So he said they're going to see war, and they're going to go back. The problem is, why does the pasuk start with Ha'am, the nation, and then the end it says, "Vayaseh Elokim et Ha'am v'derech Yamidbar yansu v'chamushim b'nei Yisrael me'ez Mitzrayim." Then he used b'nei Yisrael. What's this between Ha'am and b'nei Yisrael? Why use two languages from B'nai Israel? And the third question is, why are they afraid to fight? The next pasuk says that V'chamushim olu B'nai Israel Me'ez Mitzrayim. Rashi says they came out prepared for war. They came out with weapons and everything, right, to fight. So why are you afraid to fight? And who is this Ha'am and who is the B'nai Israel? So there's a Zohar that says, What's the difference? Sometimes the Torah uses Ha'am, sometimes it uses B'nai Israel. What's the difference between them? Am, nation, and B'nai Israel. Zohar says, whenever it says Ha'am, is going on Erev Rav. When it says B'nai Israel, it's going on the Jewish people. So with this, using this Zohar, I want to explain this Pasuk. It says here, Paro sent who? The Erev Rav. He didn't have to send the B'nai Israel, because B'nai Israel was taken by Hashem. Because last in Parashah it says, right, like passage says, and Hashem took out the Jewish people. So who sent the Erev Rav? Paro. Then it says, Ki karov hu, it's close. Just the opposite. If it's close, you better take this road. You get to Israel fast. You don't have to be 40 years in the desert. You don't have to do the Egel. You want to have all the sins in the desert, right? You take it to the Jews, to take through the Plishtim, and you're going to be in Israel in 8 days. Why do you have to go 40 years in the desert, right, around the desert for 40 years? And what is Ki karov hu? So I saw, as they say, one sefer explains like this. He says, if you go to Parashat Noach, when the Parashat explains all the sons of Noach, right? Parashat says, "Ubnei Cham, Kush, Umitzrayim, Uput, Uknaan." Cham had 4 kids: Kush, Mitzrayim, Uput, Uknaan. Who were the kids of Mitzrayim? It says, "Umitzrayim yalad et Ludim, ved Anamim, ved Lehavim, ved Naftuchim." So the question is, who is Plishtim, right? Hashem says, "I can't take it to Plishtim because Kikarov who? What is Karov? They're very close." So he explains, he said like this then, Ve'et patrusim, ve'et kasluchim, asher yatzu misham, plishtim, plishtim ve'et kaftorim. From them came out plishtim. So Rashi says, who's plishtim? Rashi says, mishnem yatzu. Plishtim came from patrusim and kasluchim. How? Shayu patrusim, kasluchim, machlifim, mishkar, mishotahem, elu la'elu. They used to give their wives back and forth. They used to exchange wives, right? So plishtim ahu, Mamzerim, the Mamzer. So we see from Parashat Noach that Plishtim and Mitzrim are relatives, right? So now, if Mitzrayim, the Erev Rav came out of Mitzrayim, he says when the Pasuk says, Kikarov hu, it means the Erev Rav were very close to Plishtim. So they came out of Mitzrayim. Now they have to go to war. So now Erev Rav is thinking, well, we're going to fight with Plishtim? They're our cousins. We cannot fight our cousins. But at the same time, we can't fight them because we accept upon ourselves to be Jewish. We're the Erev Rav now. We're joining another nation now. So what do you do now? So Hashem says, I'm worried they're going to go back. If they go back, the Jewish people see them going back. Millions of people are going back. They're also going to go back. So Hashem says, I won't take you through this way. I'm going to take you through another way. You understand? That's the answer he gave. But I had a question on this answer. Hashem is worried about the war, right? In this parasha, they're all going to fight with Amalek, right? Why over there you're not worried? Why about Amalek you're not worried? But Amalek, Moshe is raising his hand, everybody's looking at Hashem, at God, right? They're fighting, he puts down their hand, they're losing the war. Why over here they should also fight? Why over here you don't want to fight, over there you don't want to fight? So I'm going to leave the question for now. I have no answer for the question.